Welcome to Interactive Friction, ladies and gentlemen. I am Brandon Lee Carey. Joining me, as always, is racist stereotype Samuel Callahan.
Not gonna say
and
anything.
And now we're being, invaded because, of course, we are.
I think it's a computer, because it's all like fixers have invaded the island. Is how you want these things to go. And that's it.
So, like,
moving on.
That was a pointless waste of time.
Yep, that just wasted a couple minutes of my time. A couple seconds, even. Got a new skill point, so you can put it to hacking.
Yeah, scare mat.
Disable enemy reinforcements. No, I don't care about online contracts, game. I really don't.
No one does. That was... Like, it might have been a cool idea, but it's just like, I don't care.
It's needed a better game attached to it.
Oh, this, you know, talking about the last episode. Where she's feeling bad.
Yeah.
So far, yeah.
Yeah. So far.
Okay, look, I understand if you're scared.
Oh my god! How fucking patronizing!
No one asked me to stay.
I understand if you're scared. Like, you don't have the audio.
She's pissed because she wants to be your friend and you're not... Like, at all a nice person.
Like, even without the audio, can you just look at that, like, cocky smile?
Yes,
like, dude, if you're
yes.
scared.
I could use your help.
Like a team.
Also, this music sounds sure, a lot like the music that plays in Life is Strange, which is weird.
This is supposed to be, like, a friendship-building moment, but it just comes off as the most patronizing piece of shit. Or maybe I'm just assigning traits to this game that don't exist because I hate this game so much.
I mean, it's not like, aside from that one line, seems alright, this cutscene,
yeah.
But like, that was just a really weird way to start off, where he's like, because I get this supposed to be playful, but just, you know, we exist in such a world where, like, just Aiden the white guy putting down the woman, just no matter what he says, it looks bad. That was not cool.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe I am being too hard in this game.
I mean, we definitely are. Like, it's really not, like the worst thing ever. Sure, that like we seem to make it out to be.
No, it isn't. But
it's
like,
I just expect. I have a high standard for games when it comes to the.
I expected so much more from this game, and what I got was like not that.
Yeah.
Look at that. Which makes me angry and bitter, and cynical.
Oh, good. They're not typical gangbangers.
Yippee, we're not quite racist stereotypes, just kinda sorta are.
It's like a fortress.
Choir member. Let's see what we got. Attempting new world record. Married since graduation. I was trying to think, are they assigning alright traits to these people?
I like they're assigning civilian traits, which is good. Good. Assigning these civilian traits. Ugh. Good relief.
For the elevator.
You've done this before.
I admit nothing.
This is really weird to hear Clara and Aiden talk in the background, and they're like trying to be all weirdly playful and flirty. It's throwing me
off. It doesn't really work.
It's a noble attempt, I guess, but it's just, I don't know.
I wish that Clara didn't have to be like the romantic friend.
Yeah. I mean, I remember we talked about that.
Just a couple minutes ago.
Yeah, but like also way back when on an old podcast episode when I played Infamous Second Son, and I got so pissed that it's like, oh, here's the female character, and now they're gonna be romantic partners because she's the female character.
Of course, yeah.
And I just found that really upsetting.
Well, I mean, to be fair, we could use more Delson Augustine / Vic in our lives. I understand. I understand what they were going for there.
Mm-hmm. I just liked. That's
no, I'm
why
being
I,
I'm being willfully obtuse.
Yeah, but that's why I liked. What was it? First Light? Was the name of it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was great.
That gave her an actual fucking character.
Yeah, she does what she does.
She do what she do, bruh.
I'm trying to reset that timer. Let's see, got that one, there we go, and we're good. Alright, next floor. Got a lot of arcade machines for
No discernible reason?
For Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon. That game's pretty good.
Wow.
Yeah, you know, Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon, the arcade game. It's a six-button fighter.
I'd play it.
Also, they're pretending to play a game, but it just says insert coin.
I mean, I can't really hold them for that. Most people probably won't even notice.
I do find it funny that the arcade machines are a game of their brand, and then game of nothing.
Did you read his fact, Ken? Frequently searches 187. I don't get it.
You can look that up, but I have no idea what it is. I don't know if that's a reference. Banned from schools. Family history of mental illness. Post all your videos online. Give me something for your game.
So for those of you who aren't familiar, and that will, I guess, I will include Sam as well.
Sure.
The story behind Iraq is that he is someone from the area who decided he went to join the army and fought in Iraq, which is where he got his namesake from. So when he got home, he did what comes naturally, which is, of course, form a gang and teach them all the tricks he learned in the military.
Did they ever have any kind of commentary about him trying to be a normal, productive member of society, or he just immediately went to the gang?
No, he immediately went to the gang.
Got it.
You know, there are people in the military who go in just to do that, and that is true.
The IP address is coming from that room.
I really can't help but scream racism when I hear that backstory. I really can't.
Just like the idea that's like somebody learns all these techniques, it's coordination. It's like I'm using it to form a gang.
Of course the black guy will form a gang. Of course he will. Yeah. Why not? And
I can't help it.
That infuriates me on a very fundamental level.
This is a great conversation.
It really is. Like, I don't know what to say because it's fucked up. It really is. It's more fucked up than his fucking hairdo. Which I'm just noticing, and it's bad.
Mr. Quinn's on speaker.
And this is Bedbug, who I like more because he's someone I can sympathize with a bit more. His story is that basically he wants to impress Iraq, and he's trying to do all this stuff to make him look good in his brother's eyes.
Yeah.
Or, I don't know if the brothers are cousins, but they're related for sure.
I can't remember. I want to say cousins, but I could be wrong.
Your guests are my guests. Listen, I don't honestly care. You know, he's kind of a bumbling guy, so he keeps fucking up when all he's trying to do is just to be a productive member of his gang. Which
also, I just want to point out how very, what's what I'm looking for? How very nice that he was put on speakerphone rather than regular. Like, oh, what a nice coincidence this is. We're hacking in. He happens to be put on speakerphone.
Yeah.
You know, but that's video game thing. I'm not really gonna complain about that.
Just the fact that they don't, like Jesus. Iraq, of course, just goes right from, like, a war to a gang and becoming the leader of a gang, like, that infuriates the piss out of me. And part of that is, just, of course, as an American, I tend to have more reverence for the military than most countries do.
Doesn't our countrymen do? Talking about his past during, like, his boss fight or whatever? Like, he talks about the war, if I remember correctly?
Yeah, or during some of his dialogues, too.
Yeah. Has a lot of potential. You know, especially when it comes to, like, they really could have had a commentary or a dialogue about the idea of veterans coming back and not being able to get work, which is why I asked about that earlier. If the thing was, like, he tried to get a job, and then he couldn't, and that's why he started the gang. He's like, I tried to just do what I could, but nobody
But this was handled in a completely wrong way. Like, he didn't even try. He went into the army specifically to learn the tactics, and then bring him back to the gang life. Which is a thing that does have real life, but it's not that common, at least as far as I'm aware.
It's also...
And it's really fucking racist.
It's also just... It's weird to present without any sort of, again, commentary on it. Like, what is they have to say about that? Like, I guess the general consensus would be Ubisoft saying that's a bad thing, but it's like, what else about it?
Yeah. And this goes back to this game having, like, no political commentary whatsoever, which is a damning political commentary in and of itself.
Yeah. Probably doesn't help that in the end you end up killing him rather than, like, helping him out of this or something. It's just like, nope, you kill him.
And we'll get to how much Aiden Pierce mistreats the good boy in the relationship, which is Bedbug. We'll get to that in a moment.
Oh, that part I remember. It's the way he treats Bedbug is messed up.
Yeah, really fucked up. Remember, if Arak wasn't in a gang, Bedbug wouldn't be either.
Yep.
This is getting complicated.
Like, he is kind of guilty just having no brain for himself.
Find Mickey. He'll slip up. I know Damien. I have to be patient.
And just not really being very good at being a gangster. Which, you know, I can sympathize with. I also have no talent when it comes to violence and drugs.
You can really work on that.
But, like, it's just, on a very deep level, I am infuriated by the way, like, this plot is just introduced, it just happens, and there's no commentary on it whatsoever.
Yeah.
And I shouldn't be, because that's, like, this game's fucking MO.
I read the news.
Yeah.
But it's like, this one in particular, this is something that you just cannot do without bringing some sort of commentary on it.
Yeah.
Can't. Otherwise, it just comes off as crass.
Like I said, that at best, you could probably say Ubisoft just says everything is bad. It's like, oh, surveillance is bad, and like what Arak does is bad. It's like, well, why is it bad? Further explain why it's bad. Like, they don't really go into it. It just kind of, it exists as set dressing
for the purpose
of combat. It's like, Arak does all the military stuff so that you can fight military dudes.
It comes off as a very crass and, like, awful way of misusing those tropes. At least it does to me. I don't know, like, I might be in the minority there.
What's going on?
But, man, it we're not God fucking damn it.
Not anymore. Nikki, just don't listen to his bullshit.
You afraid he'll give up your secret?
At least with Damien, I can see what they're trying to do. I just don't know what they were trying to do with the Arak stuff. I'm not sure what the point was originally supposed to be.
I'd be curious to go see if there's an interview out there somewhere about that, where they ask about the characters and such.
Well,
like, what was he supposed to do for the plot? Like, what was his job originally? And what did they deviate? And what deviations they did from there?
Also, if this is a mission I'm thinking of, this one ended up taking me like half an hour to an hour or something like that. If it's the one I'm thinking of.
If it's bad enough, we can split this into two parts. Mm. You got plenty of time on this episode.
See if it's the one I'm thinking of.
Oh man, I know this is that mission. Oh yeah, this is that mission.
Yeah, this is the one that I remember failing over and over.
This is the one where you cannot be detected, if I recall correctly.
Yes, that's what I remember failing. It's like, you mess up once, start over.
Yeah, this took a long time too. Like, this is also the problem with this part of the game, is that there's a lot of back-to-back just fucking long-ass missions.
Yeah,
like, because again, because the fucking the substations of the tower took at the island took me an hour. The one where you're hacking into Arak's compound took another hour, and this one took another hour, if I recall correctly, too. Like, this is a series of long missions where you're going to fail repeatedly over and over again, and that is just not fun to have that compounded into one section of the game.
Why does he have a C2S box just sitting on the outside of his house? Why?
Yeah, because why not?
But why? What? What? What?
Bedbug. How the fuck did that happen?
I haven't seen him yet.
How did that happen?
I don't know. That's a
video. Did you say Bedbug was killed?
He did it again! Brandon, am I doing something wrong here?
I don't... Maybe you have to be stealthier.
Yeah, maybe I'm supposed to be, like, in cover when I intrude or something? He's, like, seeing me? But I haven't seen him yet.
Well, that wouldn't explain why he's being shot at and killed.
Okay, let's try this again. Hack. Start hacking.
That wouldn't explain why he's being shot at and killed, would it?
I don't think so. Okay.
I don't think I had that happen to me the last time I did this.
I don't remember that ever happening before. That's why
I'm fucking bizarre.
Confused.
Really weird, dude.
Let's see, I just need power routed down. There we go. Yeah, so he got killed twice inside his own house? Also, he's Iraq's cousin.
Did he kill himself? I guess?
That's what I thought, and I was like, that's grim. For weird.
Or did his grandma kill him?
His grandma like, Bedbug, you're being detected, I have to shoot you now.
Bedbug, there's this white man outside, I know he's something to do with him, so I can't let you live.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know what X-Men was trying to pull off there, because it didn't make any sort of sense. Key murder suspect
in what? Well, I guess in any number of killings at some point.
Yeah. Operation... Iraq's Skies of the Viceroys. I'm surprised Iraq knows what Viceroy is.
Yeah, now that we're seeing Bedbug again, I am kind of bummed out about this. I'm like, man, he's a good kid in a bad situation. And then Aiden Pierce, like, I think even people that defended this game saw that point, because I remember, like, seeing reviews of it, and people is just messed up.
This makes me sad.
Yeah, it's just depressing the way he treats him.
Because honestly, like, if Bedbug, like, again, like he was saying, if Bedbug was in a different situation, he would turn out to be a very decent kid.
Yeah, he's a good kid.
Just live with his grandma. But, like, fucking Aiden Pierce, like, destroys this man's life.
Yeah, because
And you'll see that in a moment, ladies and gentlemen, but, like, this guy gets treated probably worse than any other person in the game. I'm not even, like, hyperbolizing there, though.
I want to say that I remember, like, the first time playing this game alone and just, like, getting to the scene where you're just basically harassing the shit out of him near the fountain or whatever and just going, like, I'm uncomfortable right now.
Like, no joke, when I thought about it, I no joke have a pit in my stomach from what's about to happen in this game.
Yeah, like, I just remember feeling
like, I'm about to cry, no joke.
What?
No, not that far, but like,
I followed him and then I got shot and then killed.
Like, this part of the game leaves me very uncomfortable.
Yeah. I swear, like I said, just playing it alone and feeling very off about it. Just going like, I'm supposed to root for Aiden Pierce, right?
I found myself rooting for Bedbug.
It's like, Bedbug, you deserve a better life than this, man.
Like, it's not even like, Aiden Pierce isn't even like, if you help me, I'll help you get out of this shitty situation. No, like, Aiden Pierce, like, you help me or I'll break your fucking arm. And kill you afterwards.
And again, would have made more sense if Aiden Pierce was supposed to be like the villain situation. If it's just kind of like, yeah, of course he's a villain, he would do that.
Like, of course, I'll take advantage of this helpless member of this gang. But like, we're supposed to root for this guy, remember? And the reason that they attacked you because that was gang territory you were in.
Oh, you're supposed to like.
It's in red.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can't enter that road directly because that's where that's their part of their patrol pattern. You were driving so gingerly, and I do not recall doing that at all when I did this section.
What, did you drive like you really hard stop and start?
Yeah, stop, start, stop, start.
Yeah, I think it's because I've done so many of these in so many games that I'm kind of used to like how fast you're supposed to go.
And I don't mean that to be a joke, like I commend you for being able to do that because like my fingers can't do that in these kinds of games.
Could also be that I play a lot of racing games. Gem and Bedbug will be buried. Also, I do like to sort of like RP when it comes to like tailing missions where it's kind of like, yeah, you find good places to stop and it'll look
correct. I don't like tailing missions.
No, I don't, but I just like RPing games. I like role playing the character.
I like doing that sometimes. Sometimes in Oblivion when I play, I will wear like an actual like outfit when I'm in town and I'll put my armor on when I leave the town gate.
Yeah. I mean, that's why they had mods in, like, Skyrim, where it was stuff like Wet and Cold, where it's like you have to wear hoods when it rains outside.
And my favorite part was, like, getting, like, my favorite item in Oblivion is, no joke, the blue suede shoes. I don't know why, but I love blue suede shoes.
So sweet. So I think this is the part that I must have failed probably like 30 times over.
Yeah, this is the worst. This is like the worst part of this mission. This is like one of the worst missions in the game.
Because I think if I remember correctly, you can't... Because I remember the first time or several times I tried it, I tried tailing him with the cameras, and then the game's like, no, you can't do that. Like, you have to tail him physically.
Yeah, you had to physically tail him.
Which seems counterintuitive to having
again,
cameras.
Again, because like we were saying earlier, when this game records distance in your markers, it's like actual distance between Aiden Pierce and the target, not between the viewpoint and the target, which is a very key distinction.
Yeah, it just seems oddly counterintuitive, considering that you have him. Forgive the.
You're
him
at a point where
you can. And you have camera footage of him. Like, I just don't see why we need to physically be near him. This just seems stupid.
Especially since we've demonstrably hacked into people's phones with cameras.
Yeah.
Demonstrably several times in the story at this point.
I just don't see why this wouldn't be the safer option if there's cameras everywhere. It's like, yeah, we'll just stare at them from here.
Yeah. And again, it's just because this game has a fucked up way of doing, like, distance monitoring. Because you were more than 6 meters away in this camera. But in there, you were 6 meters, because that's how far Aiden Pierce is from Bedbug.
Don't turn around.
So it's not like, it's not the actual distance between the viewpoint in Bedbug, it's distance between Aiden Pierce's physical position and Bedbug, which, that is a distinction that really makes this level really annoying.
Please turn around! Oh god, we haven't failed this yet! We could do this in one shot, Brandon! We're almost there!
I'm not gonna hold my breath. You are not saying to me you've done this in one shot until I've seen it.
We can do this.
Until then, I will not believe you. I refuse to. I've been burned too many times by this fucking mission.
This is the worst. But we can.
Sorry, Sam, but I will not believe you until I see it for my fucking self.
I know.
I do think you are allowed to self-take down dudes, though.
Possibly. Probably. I don't trust it, though, is the problem.
Yeah, I understand completely. And that guy behind you scares the piss out of me right now.
Yep, I'm just gonna go...
Yes, that guy behind you scares the piss out of me right now.
I love the idea of detection meters where someone could stare at you for a couple seconds and be like, that looks kind of weird, you just escape at the last moment and you're like, well, I guess it was nothing. It's just weird.
I forget what Bedbug's doing that, like, we can use the... He, like, making a drug sale without... Iraq's
yes, that's what it was.
Assistance,
yeah,
or
working,
permission.
He's working without contacting Iraq, so we're gonna use that to blackmail him if I remember correctly.
Oh right, yeah, because I remember we're using this to get blackmail evidence on him, but I forgot what the actual like transgression was.
Yeah,
he's in his car now.
Yeah, he said he was carrying weight, so I think it's drugs. All right, I'm gonna take down this
you
guy.
You just take. Can you just like knock him out, please?
Yeah, I didn't know if that would work, but turns out it's fine. I can see the target, thank you!
He's right fucking there, dude.
Oh my god, that was close. Oh god.
Oh my god, yes. I'm catching up now, like, you were like 1 second away from losing his mission.
Alright, so, this is the part of the mission I remember failing a lot, was the part where I think you have to follow Diggs.
AKA Rabbit.
Yeah.
Renowned Domino's player. Who gives a fuck? I do think it's interesting that income is only $18,000 per year. Like, that could be an interesting little social commentary. Like, these guys, they don't make a lot of money because that's why they're gangsters in the first place.
Yeah, but it's just one of those, like, that's a particular case where it's like, we're the one making that commentary, though. And it's not like the game explicitly needs to do so. Like, I'm all down for me understanding these things ourselves. But it's just one of those things of like, so, like, can we talk about that?
Also, that CTOS picture of Bedbug is not flattering. At all.
Oh, I didn't realize that. He looks really stupid.
That is not fucking flattering at all.
Well, changes.
That is the,
apparently it
that
changes.
Is the
Look
worst.
At it. It changes a couple times over.
That is the worst fucking picture. Oh my god.
Call Rabbit. Right, because you're supposed to guide Rabbit. This is the part I remember failing so many times.
The guy who just saved your ass.
Alright, so we made it through part one without dying once. Let's see if we can do part two.
Look, just get me out of here, man, and I'll tell you.
Alright, pay attention.
Why can't I just kill everybody? Well, maybe it's because, like...
I know, this is the part where, like, why can't main Pierce just, like, murder everyone like he does all the time?
Maybe it's because they would...
Why is this time when he gets a fucking conscience? Of all the times.
Because he needs the information from him, and he's too far away to beat up.
That's okay, kill everyone else!
Ain't going out like this.
Why not?
The couch next, I believe?
Yeah, you're supposed to tell him when to move.
Yeah, I swear what to do, it's just a matter of... I'm trying to remember exactly what cameras I can hook onto. Here we go. I don't think...
Yeah, this is not a fun mission at all. This is, in fact, an unfun mission.
Okay, now. Go.
I was afraid of that.
Rabbit, wait! Shit!
I've got a line on Hitler's toupee.
You know what I remember why I restarted this so many times? It's because I refused to let him get caught, even though it seemed like the game will let you. I think I just ended up restarting it like 30 times over. But I doubt it does anything different.
Oh, if you just kill everyone, that's fine, then do it.
I didn't know I could. I thought it would just instantly fail, but I guess not.
Yes,
so.
Same here. That's what I thought too. Okay, never mind, take it back. Right, just kill everyone.
Yeah, just the Aiden Pierce way.
There is no better way to do this than to murder the shit out of everything. Green horses have been called too late.
Oh well. That's what I have a grenade launcher for.
Do you have grenade launcher ammo on you?
Yes. Yeah, I've got 9.
Ooh, plenty.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't remember what the difference is if you escort him out. I think it's just he gives you similar dialogue. I doubt it's much different. Maybe it reveals a bit more, but since I've already played this game, it's whatever.
Shit. Rax put a kill command on Bedbug. I need to show up in this place and deal with these guys.
Leave the area.
Leave the area.
Whoop! Okay.
Oh man.
On time?
We should end this soon.
Okay. I don't know what the next mission is. So.
This is a big episode though.
Yeah.
No place in a gang. I've seen this happen to a few guys. They don't pull their weight and they get torn down hard. But if Bedbug can survive it, Joey's got what it takes. Iraq won't just save face, he'll embrace the kid. Show him off.
Where has Aiden Pierce seen this before? Like, did they ever talk about what Aiden Pierce did before all this?
Apparently, like, he's been a vigilante for almost his entire life. Even when he was a kid, he started beating up bullies in high school.
Okay, so you would have some kind of familiarity.
Like, literally his entire life has been spent doing this shit.
That's a thing that should have some commentary, because I would love to hear more about that. Like, what that does to a person.
Like, apparently that's why Nikki doesn't like talking to him very much, because she's like, I'm sick of you going into fights and getting injured all the time, and I can't stand it anymore, so I don't want to talk to you. And done.
Can you do that?
Huh. That's actually interesting. I wish the game told me that.
It's in his fucking audio logs.
Of course it is.
Like, he spent,
everything's in the audio logs!
Yeah, it's... He has the Batman story where, like, his father left him because his father was someone who was a vigilante.
His father was a vigilante?
Yeah, and it, apparently, like, Aiden Pierce is... It's just, like, something that's in the blood.
Yeah, you know, I got it in the blood just to beat the ever-loving crap out of people.
Out of criminals.
Same difference. Take years. Everyone's a criminal.
So, like, he started training in how to fight. And how to read people. And then Damien taught him how to hack. And now he's, like, this ultimate cyber vigilante.
This game.
That's his background story, is that, like, he spent his entire life preparing and readying himself to beat the shit out of criminals. He is trying really hard to be fucking Batman. I'm not even kidding.
He read a lot of Batman as a kid. Really into it.
Like, except instead of his parents dying, his father just became a vigilante and left them.
I have to go save the people! All right. Oh, this is a great cutscene.
I really wish that was there was more to his story than that, but that is literally it. Oh my god, this cutscene.
Well, I guess you guys have to wait till next time to see what's up with this mysterious ice cream truck.
Yeah.
Because it's...
Be sure to tune in next time for Interactive Friction.
Same
IF time, same IF channel.
Definitely same channel, maybe not same time, depending on how it goes. But we'll see you guys next time, so bye everybody.
Take care, guys.